Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and with your spirit. United once again with Jesus in the celebration of the Eucharist, we strengthen ourselves with prayer, and with Jesus with us, strengthening our hope and our love. My dear friends, let us now prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, asking the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Don't you see that it is those who rely on faith who are the sons of Abraham? Scripture foresaw that God was going to use faith to justify pagans and proclaim the good news long ago when Abraham was told, "In you all the pagans will be blessed." Those, therefore, who rely on faith received the same blessing as Abraham, a man of faith. On the other hand, those who rely on the keeping of the law are under a curse, since Scripture says, "Cursed can be everyone who does not persevere in observing everything prescribed in the book of the law. The law will not justify anyone in the sight of God, because we are told, the righteous man finds life through faith. The law is not even based on faith, since we are told, the man who practices these precepts finds life through practicing them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by being cursed for our sake, since Scripture says, 'Cursed be everyone who hanged on a tree.' This was done so that in Christ Jesus the blessing of Abraham might include the pagans, and so that through faith we might receive the promised Spirit." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. I will thank the Lord with all my heart, the meeting of the just and the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord, to be pondered by all who love him. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. Majestic and glorious his work, his justice stands firm forever. He makes us remember his wonders, the Lord is compassion and love. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. He gives food to those who fear him, keeps his covenant ever in mind. He has shown his might to his people by giving them the lands of the nations. The Lord will remember his covenant forever. Alleluia, alleluia. The prince of this world will now be cast out. And when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all to myself, says the Lord. Alleluia. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus had cast out the devil, some of the people said, It is through Beelzebul, the prince of evils, that he casts out devils. Others ask Jesus as a test or a sign from heaven. But knowing what they were thinking, he said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself is heading for ruin, and a household divided against itself collapses. So too with Satan. If he is divided against himself, how can his kingdom stand? Since you assert that it is through Beelzebul that I cast out devils. Now, if it is through Beelzebul that I cast out devils, through whom do your experts cast them out? Let them be your judges. But if it is through the finger of God that I cast out devils, then know that the kingdom of God has overtaken you. So long as a strong man, fully armed, guards his own palace, his goods are undisturbed. But when someone stronger than he is attacks and defeats him, the stronger man takes away all the weapons he relied on and shares out his spoil. He who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters. When an unclean spirit goes out of a man, it wanders through waterless country, looking for a place to rest, and not finding one, it says, 'I will go back to the home I came from.' But on arrival, finding it swept and tidy, it then goes off and brings seven other spirits more wicked than itself. And they go in and set up house there, so that the man ends up by being worse than he was before." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. One of the main themes that the readings offer us to reflect on today is that the foundation, really, and the real focus is Jesus. And it is through Jesus that we unite ourselves. This is the point of which where our faith and our goal in life is focused, Jesus himself. And the gospel we've heard today certainly speaks about looking at always at the power of Jesus' love. It is through Jesus that we can not only re-energize our faith life, but also go back to understanding what our faith is all about. Certainly, we may wander afar from understanding of our faith, but let us go back to the very foundation of our faith, Jesus. More so, we, in our journey, spiritual journey, God has always been with us. He is there for us, and he is there with us. My dear friends, let us renew, refocus once again ourselves, our spiritual lives with Jesus, deepening our knowledge of him, especially through the reading of the scriptures, our prayer as well, and also rediscovering the treasures and beauty of our traditions. This can be a tool for us to refresh our faith, re-strengthen our faith once again, especially during this pandemic time. And in refreshing, renewing our faith, we might see once again our focus, our hope in Jesus. As we unite ourselves in Christ, let us come confidently to God with our prayerful intentions. that the Church may be renewed and give faithful witness to the proper values of life and so help restore a fallen world. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That Christian believers may have the courage to speak out boldly in the name of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That we may give wholehearted support in upholding the truth and in opposing the subtle influences of evil. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That the sick and the handicapped may receive the comfort of God's love from those engaged in caring for them. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who have died may be received in the fullness of God's kingdom, especially Patrick O'Halloran, whom we remember in today's of his anniversary. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, as we offer our prayers, we thank you for your Son who conquered sin and death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy Church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by our commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Let us now pray with confidence to the Father and the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite you now to take this moment to pray the acts of spiritual communion for some moments of your personal prayer. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you for participating and joining with me this live stream of our Eucharistic celebration. Join me once again this Sunday at 10 a.m. for our live streaming of the celebration of the Eucharist, as we continue to pray for one another, to be united with Jesus in this offering of the Eucharist, and always to be united in spirit with Jesus with us, carrying us in this journey. Let us always strengthen ourselves with the love of God, with our hope, with Jesus. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.